So taking matter forward, I will discuss how regulation of respiration occurs through chemical mechanism. So chemical mechanism, the ingredient of chemical mechanism through which our exchange or our concentration is compromised regarding with transportation of gases begins with chemoreceptors. So chemoreceptors are those receptors which are stimulated by or which can affected by concentration of oxygen and altered concentration of oxygen and altered concentration of CO2. So chemoreceptors, what are chemoreceptors? Chemoreceptors are basically nerve endings, group of nerve endings which stimulates easily by oxygen and CO2 concentrations. When concentrations are getting affected, these chemoreceptors are being stimulated because chemoreceptors are specific for specific processes. So as far as our regulation of respiration is concerned, it is 100% related with those chemoreceptors which lies on our peripheries or which lies on brain, which is present in deeper part of medulla oblongata. So what happens and which factors become the stimulator for our chemoreceptors and how respiratory process regulates, because when inspiration starts, expiration stops. When expiration starts, inspiration stops. So this cyclic event depends on the regulation. So regulation is very, or it plays an important role to regulate or to control our respiratory process. So what happens whenever CO2 concentration is increased, because the condition is everything is in normal state, but the condition alters according to situation, according to circumstances. So whenever CO2 concentration is increased, at that time CO2 passes into brain through crossing blood-brain barrier, and at the site where it reaches, there H2O plus CO2, water plus CO2 reacts with each other, and with the help of carbonic anhydrase enzyme, it forms carbonic acid. And next to this, carbonic acid dissociates into H+ and HCO3- ions. So we can easily understand that H+ ions increases as CO2 ions increases firstly. It is clear. But as a consequence of that, H+ ions increases. So acidity increases. This H+ ions concentration becomes the stimulator for chemoreceptors. So this H+ ions now stimulates our central chemoreceptors which lies in deeper part of medulla oblongata. And as it is getting stimulated, it sends messages to inspiratory center which lies in medullary center. And you know well that medullary center is governed by pontine center. So in this way, our inspiratory centers has or receives some messages which was sent from brain, and after receiving messages, our inspiration becomes more active. Or you can say rate of respiration is increased, force of respiration is increased, and now it acts like a compromising action, and our oxygen level increases because rate of respiration increases, force of respiration increases. So in this way we can conclude that after getting stimulated, chemoreceptors receives impulses or it acts on the basis of this receiving messages, and it executes an action through which CO2 concentration is getting decreased and oxygen concentration is getting increased. So this is about the chemical mechanism. Now what happened for peripheral receptors? So peripheral receptors, at first we find out the stimulator for peripheral chemoreceptors. The stimulator for peripheral chemoreceptor is partial pressure of oxygen. Whenever partial pressure of oxygen is getting decreased, it stimulates peripheral chemoreceptors, and after getting stimulated, it sends messages to respiratory centers, and as a consequence of which, again inspiratory center is getting more activated, or you can say both centers, whether it is either it is inspiratory center or it is pontine center, both become coordinated, both becomes coordinated, and after coordination our CO2 concentration becomes decreased and oxygen concentration becomes increased due to increased rate of respiration, due to increased force of respiration. It rectifies lack of oxygen. So in this way we can understand easily that chemoreceptors or chemical mechanism plays an important role in regulation of respiration. So I think it is clear to all of you. So now the next point is, what is hypoxia? So it is clear that hypoxia means less oxygen. So less oxygen is not only sufficient to define hypoxia. We have to define hypoxia as reduced availability of oxygen to tissues, because hypoxia is concerned with low oxygen, but it gives or it produces its effect on those whole cells or tissues of our human body. So reduced availability of oxygen to tissues is called hypoxia. And as you say that oxygen, the direction of diffusion of oxygen from atmospheric air to alveolar air to pulmonary capillaries, then towards cell. So it undergoes many processes or many pathways. That's why our hypoxia depends on various factors. Number one, when there is low oxygen tension in blood, it also causes hypoxia. Second one is when patient is anemic, means hemoglobin percentage is less, so carrying capacity is less. In this way also we can find out the cause of hypoxia. Next one is velocity of blood. If velocity of blood is altered or velocity of blood is slow, it means oxygen concentration becomes less to dark tissues, to dark cells, or in this way we can identify the cause of hypoxia. So as far as type of hypoxia is concerned, first it is hypoxic hypoxia, second it is stagnant hypoxia, third it is anemic hypoxia, fourth one is isotoxic hypoxia. So these are the type of hypoxia, and its effect are seen on the level at the cellular level or at the level of whole body. It is reflected as increased heart rate, it is reflected as increased respiratory rate, because if respiratory rate is increased. It means oxygen concentration becomes compromised due to increased concentration of oxygen in blood. That's why these are the effects which we can see in a physiological basis. So this is all about the regulation of respiration through chemoreceptors and hypoxia. And I will proceed in my next lecture.